वी डिस्कस अबाउट रिसेशन इन 2023 आउटलुक। रिसेंटली न्यूज़ ग्लोबल स्लो डाउन कुड हर्ट इंडिया बट डोंट वरी टू मच अबाउट रिसेशन इन 2023। इंटरनेशनल मॉनेटरी फंड्स वर्ल्ड इकोनॉमी आउटलुक हैज़ फ्लैग कंसर्न अबाउट अ ग्लोबल रिसेशन। दिस शुड वरी US एंड एडवांस इकोनॉमिक्स बट प्रोबेबिलिटी ऑफ रिसेशन इंडिया सीम्स लो। The International Monetary Fund July update of the World Economy Outlook has lowered India's growth forecast for the current year by 80 basis points to 1.4%. The revised growth projection is close to the official estimates and appears more realistic for the next year. The IMF has projected India's economy to grow by 6.1%. The revised in growth projection is attributed to less favorable external condition and rapid policy tightening. While global growth is projection at 3.2% for 2023, the IMF reported has flagged concern regarding an oncoming global recession defined as two consecutive quarters of negative growth. This could be concern for the US and other advanced economies. However, the probability of recession in India seem to be low as of now. And probability of a recession in US, the IMF report has sharply revised the US growth projection to 2.3% in 2022, a 1.4% point decline from the April report in 2023. The US economy will likely grow by 1%. This growth is expected to weaken substantially in the second half of 2023. The economy is projected to grow by only 0.6% in the fourth quarter of 2023. Latest World Economy Outlook Growth Projection. Advanced economic. First one is United States, Euro area, Germany, France, Italy, Spain, Japan, United Kingdom, Canada and other. Most growth projection in Spain and United Kingdoms. In emerging market and developing economics, India is the most highlighted country at second number after China, but projection growth top position. There are mixed signal on the possibility of a recession in the US. In the January-March quarter, the US economy posted a contraction. According to the latest estimate for the Federal Reserve Bank of Atlanta's GDP and now forecasting model, GDP for the April-June quarter is projected at -1.6%. According to this metric, recession may have already started in the US. The Federal Reserve Bank of Atlanta's analysis provides a running estimate of real GDP growth pending the release of the official estimate of the GDP, which comes with a lag. As inflation is beginning to hit spending, consumers have turned increasingly pessimistic. The University of Michigan's Index of Consumer Sentiment is at an all-time low. The median expected 1 year ahead inflation in 5.2%, much above the inflation target of 2%. However, there are other important indicators such as corporate sales and employment numbers that do not show the economy headed for a recession. Based on a variety of indicators, a survey of economists by Bloomberg puts the chance of a US recession at 38% over the next year. The IMF projected global inflation to peak at 8.3% this year. It is a projection to fall below 6% next year. Inflation in advanced economy is projected to fall 3.3% next year from 6.6% this year. Oil prices are projected to decline by 12% next year. If the actual inflation trajectory turns out to be closer to these projections, the pace of interest rate hikes could seem a moderation through not immediately but in the coming few quarters. Slim chances of recession in India. According to Bloomberg survey of economists, the probability of recession is zero for India. Inflation and a possible growth slowdown are primarily due to global shocks. The external headwinds having a bearing on the Indian economy could see a moderation. The US Federal Reserve raised interest rate by 75 basis points in its latest meeting to tame inflation. The Fed signaled that it would be set policy on a meeting-by-meeting basis rather than offering concrete forward guidance. The European central banks decided to raise the benchmark rate by 50 basis points has had to some moderation in the US dollar index. This reversal of sharp foreign outlook and a correction in crude and commodity prices have helped the rupees gain after touching the 80 per dollar marks. High frequency indicators suggested that there is a lesser probability of a sharp slowdown in the economy. Credit registered a strong growth of 14.4% for the fortnight ending 1st July. A noteworthy feature is that bank credit to industry is slowing. Sign of sustained outlooks. Data on sectoral development of bank credit shows that credit growth to industry accelerated to 8.7% in May 2022, while credit to micro, small and medium industries has shown strong growth, driven by the government emergency credit line guarantee scheme. Recently, 2 months have been credit to large industry also pick up with an increase in capacity utilization, pick up in infrastructure spending and the financing of the production linked incentive scheme. There seem to be an appetite for borrowing from corporates. With improvement in probability, capital position and asset quality, banks are in a better position to support the demand for credit. Most of the indicators in the services sector have shown a significant rebound in the past 2 months. Recent data suggests that consumers have also turned more optimistic about economic prospects. The index of consumer sentiments is set to make a recovery in July after a tepid growth in the past 4 months. The projection of declines in oil prices bodes well for India's inflation outlook and could influence the pace of interest rate hike by the Reserve Bank of India. Slowdown economy could impact India's growth prospects. While the economy has shown resiliency, it cannot remain immune to a slowdown in the global recession and a possible recession in advanced economics. Export could see moderation in the coming month after registering a record growth in 2021-22. Particularly, a recession in the US would impact India's IT services exports. While order flows from outsourced clients is still strong, profitability margin of IT firms are seem to be shrinking, owing to stagflation concern. The policy focus should be on microeconomics, stabilization, consolidation, the gain from export competitiveness and inflation targeting. Thank you very much. This is a reason behind why India not impact in recession 2023. Thank you very much.